United Arab Emirates' betrayal of the Palestinian cause predates this formal recognition of Israel. They have been playing footsie with Israel for a long, long time. The assassination of Mahmoud Mabou, who was the founder of the Al-Qasim Brigade of the Hamas in Dubai, that though is the, it was not directly done with the collaboration of the United Arab Emirates or the administration of the police over there, but there is enough evidence now to show that two things had happened. One was that CIA was completely in the know. They were working with the United Arab Emirates Police Department, monitoring Mahmoud, and also that this information was therefore obviously available to the Israelis. The second part of it is, after the assassination took place, Israel and United Arab Emirates were both embarrassed because the CCTV pictures came out showing who the assassins were. And they were quickly identified as people who had entered United Arab Emirates on passports of other countries. Australian passports, British passports, I think Irish passports, I think even German passports. So all of this meant those countries were embarrassed that their passports had been used, that it was their citizens apparently who had done the assassination. And United Arab Emirates was embarrassed that this happened right under their nose for a person who was supposed to be highly protected and who was supposed to be also under the radar of assassination by Israel. So this is all known. Subsequently, also United Arab Emirates cooperated with Israel to see that the people who were charged were never extradited to Dubai. In fact, a couple of them were arrested elsewhere, but they were not sought to be extradited. The only people who were extradited from Jordan. And even they are living freely in Dubai or in United Arab Emirates right now. So given all of this, UAE has a long history of cooperation with Israel, and along with Saudi Arabia, they have been basically working together for a long time. They have similar interests in Syria, where there's both the sides, Israelis as well as the Saudis, as well as United Arab Emirates. They both supported the breakup of Syria. They worked with the jihadi elements over there. In the case of Yemen, again, Israelis directly may not be involved, but there is no question again that the United Arab Emirates, Saudi Arabia do regard this as something which is fighting against Iran. And that has Israel as well as the American and the NATO support.